flying in airplanes is a marvel of human innovation. You're flying at incredible heights and moving at incredible speeds, all while flying in a pressurized tube in the air. But what if something happened? What if your window broke? Would you be able to survive if you were sucked out of the window completely? What would happen to your body up there, thousands of feet above the Earth? An airplane flies at 31,000 to 38,000 feet in order to reach cruising altitude. The reason you can breathe normally on a plane at this altitude is because the cabin is pressurized. That means the air pressure is greater inside the plane than it is naturally outside the plane, allowing your lungs to function properly. At around 20,000 feet without pressurization, the human body would experience a condition called hypoxia, in which your lungs can't receive the amount of oxygen required for sufficient brain function and long-term survival. Also, it is way colder outside the plane than inside, so much so that when the plane is at its cruising altitude, the outside temperatures drop below negative 60 degrees Fahrenheit. Brr! Not only can we not breathe outside due to air pressure, but we would also get major frostbite. Frostbite is when the skin tissue freezes hard like wood, and even muscle and bone can freeze. This can cause severe damage to skin tissue and blood vessels, and even result in amputation. If a window were to break on an airplane, the first thing that would happen is that there would be a very loud whoosh. That's the high pressurized air escaping through the broken window. Due to the difference in pressure, the air inside the plane would be forced to escape through even the smallest of holes very quickly. The air would continue to escape at great speeds until the pressure inside and outside the plane was equal. And what about those complimentary snacks? Anything under 1 pound inside the cabin would be lifted into the air and swirl around wildly. Items that aren't strapped in could theoretically be pulled through the vacuum of the broken window, and depending on the size of the hole, a person could get sucked out, at least partially. This has actually happened a couple of times in aviation history. One time, there was a flight where the entire windshield of the plane's cockpit shattered mid-flight. The pilots almost got sucked out of the windows, but their seatbelts kept them safe in the plane. It was freezing in the cockpit, but with oxygen masks and quick thinking, the pilot was able to safely land the plane and save everyone on board. But have people been sucked out of a plane entirely? Sadly, yes, this has happened before. This has occurred when the hole was big enough in the cabin of the plane for a person to fit through, and the plane was at a high enough altitude where the air pressure caused a vacuum. In one incident, a woman was partially sucked out of the window and later died from her injuries. However, in most cases, a securely fastened seatbelt will hold you in your seat if a window breaks. In the event of a broken window, here's what would happen. The change in air pressure would cause the air masks to drop from the ceiling. The pilots would immediately bring the plane down below 31,000 feet to quickly normalize the oxygen level in the plane. All of that would happen in a matter of seconds. The vacuum effect would cease, and it would be extremely loud, windy, and very cold inside the cabin. What is a danger from a broken window is the inability to breathe and potential damage to the lungs. That's why it's important to grab those oxygen masks quickly and place them securely over your nose and mouth. Many planes have been able to safely land with broken windows and no one has been hurt. In fact, flying is one of the safest forms of transportation, and it's highly unlikely that a window would break anyway. Windows are layered with four panes of glass that are able to withstand various pressures, protecting you and everyone else on board. So sit back, relax, and remember, the most dangerous thing on a plane is just really smelly feet.